Hey Sabre fans, I'm Maddie McNamee here with Chris Horn at JPJ after the men's basketball media day. So Chris, what was just your overall takeaway from media day?
Well, obviously, first time ever Virginia coming off a national championship. So, but it's kind of interesting. It's just a completely different team with DeAndre Hunter, Ty Jerome, Kyle Guy moving on to the NBA. A lot of new faces. That seemed to be kind of the prevailing theme. And new faces bring uncertainty. So how's it going to look? I'm not sure if anybody really knows, come next week when they take on Syracuse, obviously a challenging opponent on the road. So they're kind of getting thrown, a lot of the young guys getting thrown to the fire. Kihei Clark, Mamadi Diakite, definitely seem like they've taken more of a leadership role this year. I spoke with Mamadi for a few minutes, and really impressive. He said he went through the pre-draft process last spring, almost declared himself, but decided to come back. And he said he learned a lot about leadership going through that. So those two guys obviously will be counted upon. But I think, again, uncertainty is going to be a topic. Sounds like Coach Bennett wants to have more of a well-balanced approach this year as opposed to maybe last year's team, which they were able to get a lot of scoring from the big three through the three. And that's kind of a question mark. Who's going to step up? And with guys who haven't been in that role before, are they going to be ready to shoot it? And then, of course, can they make it? So those are the questions. But it sounds like, Coach Bennett, as always, defense is going to be the key. But he sounds hopeful. But, again, it's kind of a little bit uncertain heading into next week at Syracuse.
So one of the main, topics today was a lot of people were talking about the inexperience of the youth on the team. So do you think there should be any fear of that going into the season?
Well, I think, given the, UVA fans certainly have been, and Coach Bennett mentioned that they were spoiled with the three-point shooting that they've had, but certainly with the quality of play. And I think this year's team is certainly going to be well-coached, as every Virginia team. I think there's, I'm not sure if maybe scared, but certainly, again, uncertain. And I wouldn't be, don't be surprised if there are some growing pains associated with this team. New faces, Thomas Waldo-Tensei is a junior college transfer. His first experience in big time basketball. Cody Statman, who was here last year from Australia. When he got here from Australia last year, he didn't go through the AAU circuit, all the stuff that a lot of American basketball players go through to prepare them. So this year is kind of really his first year, I feel like, being ready to play, ready to go. Casey Morsell, a true freshman. Kihei Clark, Coach Bennett joked that he's kind of the grizzled veteran, but he's only a sophomore, so he's got some room to grow as well. And, all those guys are on the perimeter. So I think they're going to be looking to Mamadi Diakite, Braxton Key, Jay Huff for a lot of scoring. But, the uncertainty is when they're going to be able to balance that out. I think Casey Morsell, he seems mature beyond his years, and he's been battle tested in high school. So I'm kind of looking for him to step out early. But again, I think there'll be some growing pains. I think Virginia fans probably should be ready for a few growing pains at least to start the season.
So there's a lot of talking about Mamadi being this big leader on the team this year. But like you just said, Tony Bennett did call Kihei Clark a grizzled veteran. So what do you think his role is going to be on the team? Only being a sophomore too, though, what kind of leadership can he take with that?
Yeah, he played so much that, last year what he was able to do as a true freshman. And then one thing that was interesting, I did ask him about last year, he played with the cast on his wrist. And he said that really helped his mental toughness. And I feel like he went through a lot of things last year. He stepped up on the biggest stage in the NCAA tournament. So in a lot of ways, he's definitely more than just a sophomore. So I think he's tried to help the young guys. We'll see as far as his personal game, obviously shooting the three when he's got the opportunity, making more consistent quality decisions. Given the fact that he's going to be the guy at point guard, are going to be the kind of key issues for him. But again, leadership, and he's proven that he's been up to the task so far. So I think he's excited for this challenge.
So first game is a week from today, and it's on the road. It's at Syracuse. So, Syracuse kind of plays, like Tony Bennett was just saying, a different kind of game than everyone. So what should we be expecting with that? What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I guess you have a whole offseason to prepare for that zone. So I doubt they're going to change what they do. Virginia obviously blitzed them last year at Syracuse with a ton of three-point shooting. And since that's been a topic we've talked about already through this conversation, what's that going to look like? But, you know, I think obviously it's a challenge. I think it's a good thing for these guys to be, for especially the younger guys, to be exposed to the Carrier Dome, which I think we've seen the past few times UVA has played there. The crowd really gets up for Virginia, and you know, these UVA is the national champs now. And as Braxton McKee said during the media day, that they know they're going to have a mark on their back, and teams are going to, okay, Virginia, the national champs are here. We're going to want to beat them. So I think it's going to be, you know, even if they were to come out with a loss, you know, I think it's going to be a great experience to play in a tough atmosphere against what, you know, is usually a competitive Syracuse team. And then we'll see, you know, how they kind of bounce back from that. And I think it'll be definitely a good learning experience moving forward.
And then my last question is, you know, just since this team is so new, who are you most excited to see out on the court?
Yeah, well, Mamadou Diakite, when we were walking out to interview the players, was out there at the three-point shooting line and making threes, swishing threes. It's going to be interesting to see. I think he's going to have a lot of freedom this year. And this year is going to be really his first year that he's going to have the chance to be kind of the guy. And he'll be, you know, and that's going to be different for him. You know, the past few years he's had Hunter, Jerome, Guy, and he's kind of been a guy who can step up when he wants to. But he's going to be called upon to be the guy this year. And that's why I think it was a good move for him to come back instead of going to the NBA, because he'll have this experience to build on before he goes off to his professional endeavor. So I'm excited to see what he's going to do. Coach Bennett mentioned that both Mamadi and Jay Huff have been doing, it sounds like, a lot of shooting threes, but also down low in the post. Braxton Key is another guy. You know, I think he's just going to be a steady leader. And I used to cover recruiting, so just, you know, Casey Morsell is you know, highly regarded freshman that UVA really wanted. Coach Bennett seems like he's very high on him on both sides of the court, and I'm excited to see him again. He's coming from the WCAC, which produces a lot of talent, and you know, so excited to see him. And you know, I think anytime you have, even though there will be some growing pains, anytime you have some fresh faces, it's just exciting to see that talent, how they're going to mold. And obviously Coach Bennett's a proven coach, so it'll be interesting to see the identity of this team and what's going to happen.
All right, so we are now just 1 week away from the season. Thanks so much for watching.